machine?
So there are two ways of installing Redis on a Linux machine. So one way is you can install it using a package manager, and the other way is you can actually install the you can download the binaries, and then you can prepare the compiled version of the software, and then you can install it using that. So in the first case, we are going to learn about installing using the package manager. But in this situation, you will also need internet connection to be working on the server on which you are going to install Redis. Okay, so I'm assuming if you have internet connection, you can follow this step, or otherwise you can move on to the next lesson. So I have already created a script. Okay, and this script contains all the commands which is supposed to have in order to configure RAMI repository and also install Redis. So by default operating system, you know, CentOS operating system which I'm using doesn't really have Redis package available. So for that one we need to use RAMI repo. Okay, so what first three line does is it is going to install RAMI repository and going to configure it. Okay, so you can run all of these three lines one by one. Actually, I have already done it, but still for the purpose of demonstration, I'll do it again. Okay, so you can see here it shown me that there's nothing to do. It already has this package installed because I have already run it. But if you are doing it for the first time, it is going to install these packages for you. And then I'm going to run the second command. Again, in my case, I have received that, you know, there is nothing to do because these packages are already installed on my machine. Now I'm going to copy third line and going to paste it. Okay, so this has executed. And let me clear the screen. And let's see the, you know, script file again. So we have already successfully executed first three lines. So now if I do sudo yum install Redis, it is going to install Redis on this system. One thing which I want to mention is that I'm already logged in as a root user. Okay, if you are, because in order to run these package management related commands, you must be having sudo access or you must be logged in as a root user. So if you don't have a password for root user, you probably need to have, you know, your user which you are using to install Redis should have access, sudo access. Okay, that's the reason sudo commands are prefixed on each of these lines. But if you are running it as a root user, you probably can ignore this sudo and you can just go ahead with the remaining lines. Both will work. So either you log in as a root user and run it, or you log in as some other user which is having sudo access, and then you run this full line. Okay, so in my case, let me just run this one, and I'm also going to pass hyphen y after install. So what it will do is it is not going to ask me for any prompt, and it is just going to install Redis. So as you see, it has downloaded the software, and then it went on and installed the software. So if I clear the screen and I go back to my script, you will notice we have successfully executed all the commands until here. So the next command is talking about enabling Redis. So by enabling Redis, this command actually means is it is going to, you know, set up Redis to auto restart whenever the server is starting. So whenever your system reboots, Redis software is going to start automatically whenever your server is starting. If you do not set up this line, in that case, if the server goes down and when you start the server again, Redis services are not going to be started again. Okay, so basically it is not going to be started automatically. Once the server is up, you have to run the startup command to start Redis. Okay, so before I start Redis, I will probably run this enable command. Again, it depends on the need. If you do not want Redis to be starting automatically when the server starts, you should not be setting up this, you know, you should not be running this command. However, since I have ran this command, so in this case, if I restart my system, Redis is going to be started also. Okay, now before we run start command to start Redis, let us run this status command and see what it is displaying as of now. Okay, so now you can see it hasn't really, you know, we have installed Redis, but currently Redis is in inactive state. Now the way to start is you just put, you replace status with start and it is going to start Redis. And now if you do status command again, you should be able to see the status. So now we see Redis has changed to active status. And if you want to stop Redis, you run this command sudo systemctl stop Redis. Now if you run status command again, you can see Redis has been stopped. So I will start Redis again. And let's check status. Okay, so it is running. So by default, what happens is when you install Redis, it also installs a client which is called Redis-CLI. So now if I do Redis-CLI, I'll be logged into Redis client. So now you can see this Redis client is actually running on this hostname using and it is connected to port 6379. So by default Redis uses port 6379, and since it is installed on localhost, that's the reason it is showing us this IP. This is a representation of localhost. Okay, so this what this means is that Redis is successfully installed and running. Now to test it, probably we can run few commands. I will be explaining these commands to you later on. So basically, since it is a key value store, so to write anything, you write a command set. And also, if you would have noticed, it started giving us some of the suggestion based on the command which we are using. So that's again one of the features of Redis command line interface. So using set, I can write a key value pair in the Redis data store. So probably I'm going to write a color. And let's give color name is red and let's hit enter. So now we can see we have given a value of color. Okay, so color is going to be the key name and red is a value. So if I want to see it again, I can use get command and we need to pass the key name whose value we want to see. So if I do get color, I'll be getting red as the output. So you can see we have received red as the output. So similarly, I can store a lot of other things. Let's say I want to store the price of chair, so I can store that. Let's say I want to store price of other objects. I can do that as well. So now if I want to, you know, get price back of tables, I can do get tables, or I can do get chair to get the price of chair. Or if I want to see how many keys or total number of keys which are stored right now, so I can do something like db size, so which is giving me a value of 4. And if I do key star, you can see right now we have 4 keys stored in the database. So that's the reason here when you saw db size, it gave you value of 4, which means db size command is going to give you the total number of entries or key entries which are stored in the Redis database. So that's it in this session. Next session we are going to learn installing Redis without using Package Manager.